Fukaya categories. So in principle, this thing should be the following. We have a real kind of C infinity symplectic manifold, and something called B field, which is, one can think it's a two cochain representing class B in H2 of X, and take maybe 2 pi z. Then the thing should give, I'll tell you what are problems, at an infinity category of complex numbers. And in fact, will be Calabi-Yau category. Calabi-Yau dimension n, when n is half of real dimension of x. So that's kind of principle. And what is the rough idea? It's first approximation objects in category with node f of x omega p. This. Objects of this category will be, say, compact Lagrangian submanifolds. And Hamiltonian isotopy should give, if you apply Hamiltonian isotopy, it should be the same object, isomorphic object. Then home spaces between two Lagrangian, home complex between two Lagrangian manifolds should be equal to C to the set of intersection points if intersection is transversal. And by this Hamiltonian isotopy, one can always achieve it. And then when you consider any infinity structure for any k, if you want to write L infinity composition, should be such maps. It's a tensor. It's tensor coefficient, which depends on the choice of intersection point, should be equal to, so it means that you fix intersection points of L0, L1, L1, L2, and so on. It will be sum over all maps of holomorphic disks, pseudo-holomorphic disks, x such that the boundary of this disk is union of Lagrangian manifold, and it meets the intersection exactly this point. And exponent, let's say minus integral of omega over disk plus roughly I times integral over b over disk, a pure imaginary number defined up to 2 pi iz. Also, maybe we should put maybe some plus minus. What is pseudo-homomorphic disks? There's one small definition. If you have almost complex structure on X is compatible with omega, if omega of xi j xi is bigger than zero for any a real tangent vector, non-zero real tangent vector. Yeah, so that's it guarantees that for any holomorphic, pseudo-holomorphic curve, the integral of omega will be positive number if it's not a trivial curve. Yeah, so that's rough idea, and there are several problems here. So problem number one. This thing should be z-graded. This complex should be z-graded, and also we should orient the space of disks should be zero-dimensional, and we should orient the space of disks. Orientation of maybe virtual orientation of space of disks. Not to get some fundamental class. So the second problem is when I consider the area of the disk, or maybe with the class, depends on the homology class of the disk. Given class of the disk, which is in H2 of X and union of Li from 0 to K with integer coefficient. We want to have finiteness of the space of disks, and we need in particular compactness. We need a compactness, so there's a compactness issue, because I didn't say that manifold is compact. It should be not compact manifold. The third story, even for given homology class, we get some integer number in front of this story, or maybe rational number. But then there's a question why the series is converges if you summate over all degrees of the disks. Convergence of series. And fourth point, it's that presumably I should add more object. One can put like local system on Lagrangian manifolds, and I will also discuss it. Need more object. For example, we want to, this category to be triangulated, and a priori it's not triangulated. Yeah, so there are four different issues, and I'll briefly tell you what is the state of art about one. Orientation and grading first notice the following. You can consider a symplectic group, which is structure group of a tangent bundle. It contains unitary group, and it's its homotopy equivalence. Right. So unitary group is a maximal compact group here. Hence, one can speak about, and also it's homotopy equivalent to G, L, and C. So there are two groups, which are three groups, which are homotopy equivalent. And in particular, one can speak about Chern classes. Tangent bundle. And the condition which is necessary to make the grading case is 2 times first Chern class x is equal to 0 in H2xz. This is a condition. And more precisely, one needs not only the equality but some additional data just to making this equality. And data is the following. Let's consider a bundle over X with compact fiber. If you pick a point X, the fiber is fiber text is a set of Lagrangian subspaces in the tangent space. So it's a certain guy, and let's assume that n is at least one. This space has it's connected, but it's and its fundamental group is Z. One of these things is Z. So if you kill all high homotopy group adding cells, you get homotopically circle, and this circle is twice times the circle coming from canonical bundle. This guy has a two-fold covering, oriented Lagrangian manifold, and one can easily see that it's, if you put almost complex structure, you get the circle is the same as the one, and the data will be the following. The data will be a map from maybe called something like arg, will be mod by Z. It will be a map from the total space of this guy to R mod by Z, such that if you restrict it's on every fiber, you get a map to a circle, and it represents a generator of H1 each fiber, and gives a gives a generator of first cohomology of Lagrangian Grassmannian on the fiber, gives generator of H first of I mean, pull back of the fundamental class using generator for each one. So how did it arise in practice? If X is scalar manifold, and we get section gamma x kx squared, which is not vanished at any point, so you get at each point volume form defined up to a sign, Hallmark volume defined up to a sign, then you get a map, namely you take square root of this guy, which is defined now up to sign, restrict to Lagrangian, X will be Lagrangian subspace in X, and take argument of this guy, and it's defined because argument is usually defined up to 2 pi z, but because up to sense it defines model up to 2 pi z, up to pi z. Yeah, so you get this function. Okay, yeah, so that's things responsible for your manifold. And now about what about Lagrangians? It's this object of Fukaya categories should be not arbitrary object. If L X is Lagrangian, then L also maps to this total space, because at each point of Lagrangian you get its tangent tangent space. So you get a lift to this L dx, this vibration. And then we get this map arg mod pi z to r mod pi z. Then we get r. And this you get a map from Lagrangian to a circle, and this map gives a class get a class mu belonging in H1 LZ, because I get map from a circle. And what we needed, we need mu equal to zero. For it's called Maslow index. For each loop, I get certain integers. So we should get this function to be equal to zero on first homology. And additional data grading on L is a choice of a lift from L to R. Choice of map which produces composition is the argument. And then it's easy to see that for two graded Lagrangian manifolds, if intersection is transversal, for graded L1, L2, and intersection is transversal, you get a map index, kind of Z grading. You can associate certain Z grading to each intersection point. And if you interchange L1, LL2, then index goes to N minus index. So it will be Calabi-Yau duality. So the same intersection point you consider as element of complex of Holmes in one direction and another direction, and they have opposite with sum equal to N indices and get Calabi-Yau duality. Okay. Yeah, so that's a kind of standard thing which one should do about Z graded things. You should consider kind of Calabi-Yau varieties to get in symplectic sense. Now the question, I still didn't finish the story. We need orient disks. Then this Lagrangian manifold should be could be in principle not oriented, should be spin manifold in the sense that second Stifel-Whitney class is zero. This I discuss first in the case when B field is equal zero. And this is Stifel-Whitney class. More precisely, one need data, one need not equal to zero. For example, there is canonical representation of Stifel-Whitney class. You choose some cell decomposition. Choose arbitrary cell decomposition. And this Stifel-Whitney class is represented by the catchain, which is sum of all codimension 2 cells in the barycentric subdivision. You get some cell decomposition. Now you make this barycentric subdivision. This equality one should this equality of 2C1 equal to zero, it should promote to some data, namely L is compact. L is compact, yeah. And then one needed to write as a boundary of certain one chain with coefficients in Z mod 2. yeah, this will be like spin structure or choice of spin structure on your manifold. Then that if you can see Lagrangian manifold with such things, and you get some well-defined orientations. In general, if b is not equal to zero, it's some bit longer story. Then presumably, what one needs is that b restricted to L should be a torsion element in this cohomology group. And then what will happen that one should consider not L itself, but not just L, but local systems, kind of twisted by gerb. Whose class in H2 L maybe kind of C star containing is I times B plus Stifel-Whitney class, image of Stifel-Whitney class. We interpret Z mod 2 as plus minus 1 or pi Z of mod pi Z in this Z mod 2 heat. Kind of Z mod 2 embedded to C star embedded to. Okay, yeah, so that settles the question 1. Yeah, so okay. Then, but what about compactness? It's of disks with given area. Suppose I get a symplectic manifold, which is not necessarily compact, and but it's I have to say what's called paracompact. It contains a dense countable subset because C infinity manifolds in principle could be very big.
Countable at infinity.
Countable at infinity. Yeah, X countable at infinity. Infinity. Yeah, is admissible. I don't know. It's not really good word, but and if for any compact subset in X and any positive number A, real number, there exists K2 in X such that K1 sits in interior of K2, also compact, and almost complex structure G on X, say, compatible with omega, such that for any map from the two-dimensional disk to X, which is J holomorphic, such that F of boundary belongs to K1, and integral of pullback of omega of disk is less than A implies that if the whole disk belongs to K2. Yeah, so it's essentially kind of a formulated condition which is more or less tautologically what is needed to have at least for some almost complex structure have this property. Yeah, so it's kind of almost tautological condition which what I need to have a compactness, even existence, I don't really fix one. And the claim, if I'm not confused with limits, in this case, one get a canonical infinity category, which doesn't depend on the choice of almost structure, over Novikov field, which is by definition is the following. It's a set of infinite sums, ci t to ai, formal sums, countable sum, said that ci are complex numbers, ai are real numbers, and a limiting point of ai is plus infinity, and t is just a variable. I eventually want to put a t equal to e to minus 1, but put it as a formal variable. That's it. I think this the idea, I think, behind the things is this guy called Groman. He proposed something similar, but a bit more strong. I think it's kind of really maximal generality one can define this Fukaya category, at least over Novikov field. The reason is the following. It's if you want to count these disks, a series, suppose we get two Lagrangian manifolds, L1, L2. Or several Lagrangian manifolds, Lk. And you want to study this some compositions, so you want to map holomorphic disks to their union. And if you bound the area, then that it sits in some compact space, you can put some K2, so the whole thing's up to given area bounded sits in this or maybe one can say say something. Just a second. Maybe this almost complex structure. Maybe I should be a little bit more precise here. Almost complex structure on x minus k1, such that for any almost complex structure, just when j is for any j, such that j restricted to x minus k1 is j prime. So you can see the holomorphic disks, which inside satisfies some uncontrolled Cauchy-Riemann equation, but outside will be controlled. And eventually, what you go on, you just kind of. Sorry?
Is it a version of Hartog's theorem or some weakening?
No, just condition. It's just condition, which is a priori, it's not clear how to check at all. Yeah, but if condition you can check, you can exhaust for larger area by different compact set, and put one complex structure here, another complex structure here, and so it's completely formal argument with limits, nothing deep here, which guarantees the whole thing exists, and then eventually it will be also unique. So it's pretty empty. Constraint, but then one can kind of guarantee it by various means.
confused with this condition, so no Lagrangian, so any boundary condition, any Lagrangian boundary condition.
There's no boundary condition. In this story, there's nothing about Lagrangian manifolds at all.
Yeah, but in the compactness, you do have a boundary condition.
Yes, yes, no, but it's kind of a bit stronger than I forget. It sits.
So what does it mean? There are no Lagrangians at all with this.
No. It's about disks. There's no disks. This bounded area which go to infinity. That's
it. If I consider it like a totally real boundary condition, it still be compactness.
No, I need Lagrangian manifold to be compact. My Lagrangian manifolds.
There is no Lagrangian.
No, there's no Lagrangian manifold here. But I say that it sits in the union of compact of union finite union of compact guys. It sits in some compact. That's it. Yeah. Sir.
If I replace a line by the totally real. Not Lagrangian, but just totally real.
Will be also the same. As the same. Yeah. Okay. So there are various sufficient conditions. There are various kind of sufficient conditions. Some criteria when the whole thing satisfies. So. One is when X omega has a contact type at infinity. And what does it mean? It means that there exists a vector field and a compact subset such that Lixi of omega is equal to omega on x minus k. And then the following, the boundary of k is smooth hypersurface. In X, and so you get this K, and this vector field, this boundary C, looks outwards. C is directed outwards at C, and moreover, X minus interior of K is vector field. Forget about symplectic form, as symplectic form as well, is isomorphic to C times positive ray and vector field with coordinate T and vector field du dt. So it will be just kind of cylindrical end. And then automatically the things will be contact manifold. Yeah, that's a very typical situation. And it's when it holds okay if X is a cotangent bundle to Y, where Y is interior of a smooth compact manifold. Yeah, then it's one can easily see that one gets this contact boundary. So it's one good situation. The second good situation is kind of more general. So one implies two. So two gives more general class of examples. When there exists a compact subset, almost complex structure, and a function h from x to, let's say, positive numbers, which is proper, and such that, or maybe I don't even need compact subset, there exists almost complex structure and h, said that H restricted to preimage of some the tail is pluri-subharmonic. In what sense? It means that if consider a map, a germ of a map of G holomorphic map from a disk to this this H minus one of this open domain, or maybe this open domain, say, then the pullback of H is pluriharmonic function Laplacian integral pullback is non-negative. Yeah, so it also guarantees that if you stay in some up to some level set of your function, your boundary of your disk sits on boundary says that it cannot go outside by maximum principle, because then I'll get a point on the boundary when the value of h will be get the local maximal, which contradicts this condition. Yeah, this is a more stronger condition. In fact, people construct a long time ago, if you get contact type boundaries and construct at infinity this pluri function, so the six will be really strictly positive for any non-trivial disk. So you get something like Keller approximation of Keller metric. And this is pretty complicated differential geometric data. And there are reasonable examples, like in Fukaya Zedel categories, when it's really this condition sits space, not the one. But the third condition is of different nature. It's also very useful. So there exists complete Riemannian metric G on X satisfying three inequalities. So the curvature of the metric is uniformly bounded. The injectivity radius is also uniformly bounded. So there are local pieces which looks like very close to Euclidean balls. And third condition that both omega and omega inverse is a section of exterior part of cotangent bundle of tangent bundle are bounded with respect to norm metric G are bounded also uniformly. And then it guarantees really exactly this thing. It's not that for each area one can find this disk can go too far. And the reason is the following. If you have this compact set K1 and you have a disk, then the first of all, the integral of two form and integral of and Riemannian volume will be bound differ by a constant. So it means that this Riemannian volume is bounded. Riemannian area is bounded. And now if the thing is very long, so the diameter is very big and area is bounded, then it's at least at some points it should be very close to in kind of Gromov-Hausdorff distance to an interval. It should be kind of one-dimensional object. And then so it will be kind of very long thin cylinder. Injectivity radius says that it's big, so it would like sits in a Euclidean space. But then this long and thin cylinders are not holomorphic, do not satisfy Cauchy-Riemann equation badly. So that's a rough idea. And it's really different criteria, so it's not related to one and two in any way. Yeah, and this kind of fundamental question for my future story will be the following. Suppose X omega C is holomorphic symplectic manifold. And assume that it's is embedded is open dense open symplectic leaf. To compact Poisson, maybe algebraic, say, Poisson right x prime, x bar. The question is in the situation x, and I take real part of omega c, which will be automatically real symplectic form, admissible to infinity. So this is a situation which I need for quantization in deformation quantization sense, and this is in Fukaya sense. So it's true for many examples. Yeah, first it's definitely true if X is cotangent bundle. It's explained it in real case is okay. Or if X is C cross to C cross is kind of standard form. To some power n, product of copies of standard multiplicative torus. And also it's true if x is, if dimension of x is a surface, and x bar minus x is a divisor, not necessarily with normal crossing. So in surface case, the story is the following. If it's a divisor, one can easily check. It could be not normal crossing. You make blow-ups to make it normal crossing. It will be still Poisson divisor. You can reduce the equation to normal crossing. In the normal crossing case, the third criterion works very well because essentially you can have poles of order 1 and then you get kind of like cylindrical ends, or pole of higher order, you get very open ends, and it's very easy to construct this metric. It's a very rough picture. Also, harmonic function, and I don't know how to get. Yeah, so this third criterion number 3. Third criterion is applicable. And the thing is kind of not true, at least not on the nose true. In the simplest example, consider R4 minus 0, and we take standard form. At infinity, the behavior is okay, but near zero, it's wrong. And it's completely parallel to kind of first example of non compactifiable holomorphic symplectic manifold C2 minus zero. Yeah. So there's a good indication that are all the same story. Okay, so that's all about compactness and. This third point is convergence of series. Yeah, I think it's, yeah, that's a really main stumbling block in the whole story. For, I don't know how many, for 25 years. It's still open question. What we use now is kind of surrogate solution. Work over non-Archimedean field of form a series. No, this Novikov field. What really one what we need? We need some tool to go from this form of things to actual objects. We need a tool which controls number of holomorphic disks of area less than A. We want it to be growed at most exponentially in area. What is this? What is the situation here? There are some cases where we kind of understand a little bit more about Fukaya categories from homological mirror symmetry, like quintic, threefold, and so on. And in these examples, it's clear that the radius of convergence is strictly less than one. Yeah, typically you should expect to get some integer numbers, and radius convergence should be one because the coefficients of size one. But in quintic cases, radius convergence is strictly less than one, and it means that you cannot make if you try to make this is something called mirror map. It means that if a class of symplectic form is too small, then you cannot make unambiguously the meaning what is Fukaya category. You get ramified map to modular space of categories from kind of Keller modular space. And I think it's also this problem with small area will affect this Gukov-Witten program. They said that for any symplectic manifold, blah, blah, blah. But maybe for some symplectic form is too small, the whole thing will just break down. So the conjecture is that in kind of that under some conditions which we don't know yet, kind of for good examples, the whole thing Mn will be in kind of analytic part of the Novikov field, which is the set of the sums. CITAI in Novikov field, such that sum over there exists a constant this is epsilon, such that sum over CI epsilon to power AI is less than infinity. Yeah, I can see the kind of like convergent series with real exponents. Yeah, so and now the last issue about more objects. The proposal is the following, which is not yet materialized. First we choose some lambda in X, which will be compact singular Lagrangian subset. So it's closed subset, and what singular Lagrangian for example, it could be maybe sub-analytic if it's X is real analytic closed subset. And its smooth locus will be Lagrangian subvariety. Yeah, so it could have pretty horrible singularities, or maybe not so horrible, kind of like. And then the story is the following: this Lagrangian set plus this orientation z gradient choice, z gradient data which we have on our symplectic manifold. So we don't do anything like spin structure on this guy at all. So we have this derivation of twice canonical class on symplectic manifold should produce a certain DG algebra, comes like A lambda over integers, and algebra will be of some the following roughly of the following nature. We'll get a maybe finite quiver. Then edges will have set of edges will have a map to integers, so edges will be kind of z-graded, and we consider past algebra, we get graded algebra, is z-graded, and now we introduce some differential of the following form. Differential of each edge, if each edge will be finite expression, finite non-commutative polynomial, non-commutative expressions in with integer coefficients in previous edges. So it means that a set of edges should be set of edges is totally ordered. Oh, ordered. Yeah. Yeah. So you add them step by step. You add one expression differential of this guy. So you get some finite collection of some nice integer non-commutative polynomials that is equal to zero. You get this algebra, and then yeah, it depends only on neighborhood. Only on neighborhood of lambda, and then what your manifold, big symplectic manifold will do, x omega will give some not totally clear way a solution of Maurer-Cartan equation for cohomological Hochschild complex for this algebra. Kind of you deform in cohomological Hochschild complex. Lambda over Novikov thing, for example. And then the object what it
have infinitely many positive and negative degrees.
Sorry?
A lambda. It's great. It can have infinitely many.
Of course, yeah. Yes, everything, yeah. No problem, yeah. But now one can, if one gets this Maurer-Cartan equation, one can speak about finite dimensional modules, finite dimensional representation of this algebra, depending on hbar, so your algebra deform as well, and consider modules over finite dimensional over Novikov ring modules over deformed algebra. Should be also interpreted as object of this Fukaya category. X omega maybe B, yeah. Objects of enlarged Fukaya category. Yeah, in the case of smooth manifold, this thing is something very close to group ring of the fundamental group, we consider trivial representation. Yeah, that will be like original object which we have.
So, I'm sorry. There you mean in the Lie algebra of Hochschild cochains? Is that what you mean?
Yeah, it's DG. Yeah, DG Hochschild complex is DG Lie algebra.
Okay, so basically it's an infinity algebra, right?
It's an infinity structure, but also with M zero, maybe some things. Okay, yeah, but it's. So what is the rough idea of this algebra? Well, this algebra, I think this situation is more or less stabilized now. Suppose you get this Lagrangian manifold, like on plane, I get a graph. Yeah, just example in R2. Then I take a small. Sorry? A lambda.
Lambda or A lambda?
A lambda. Rough idea of A lambda.
Provided that lambda exists.
Lambda is subset, yeah. A lambda is given, I know what exists. Empty set exists. If you get.
Modules over A lambda should contain inside just compact Lagrangians, blah, blah, blah. It's large, which means that it's bigger than Fukaya.
Yeah, no, the region of Fukaya is a smooth Lagrangian, but it will be singular Lagrangian in some kind of sheaf data. Could be empty. No, for any lambda, for any lambda. And then we take inductive limit for all possible lambda. One can. If one sets it in another, one category sits is a full subcategory in another. The story is the following. This Lagrangian manifolds, the single Lagrangian manifolds are more or less the same as kind of what's called Weinstein domains, because they appear in the following way. You have open neighborhood of L and vector field psi, said that, let's say, leak psi of omega now will be minus omega. It will be kind of opposite to the things which we have at infinity. And suppose this psi at boundary looks inwards, and is directed inwards. So you really need a domain on which restriction class of omega is zero in second cohomology class, and you choose a representative which directed inverse, and then I apply the flow. So it's the things start to contract it, and generally it's contract to something singular Lagrangian guy, and conversely singular Lagrangian guy is coming from this neighborhood. There are many skeleton in this business, so we get this flow which contracts symplectic form, and you get the single Lagrangian. But now you do the following flow. On the same U, you consider something like epsilon neighborhood of L, some metric. You can see the Hamiltonian flow, which is lambda. Sorry, it's L lambda. You can see the gradient of distance function to lambda. You can see the gradient of the distance function, so you get some flow which now exists complete in both in positive and negative direction. So it's because orbits stay in a compact set, you get the flow. And what will be this very roughly, it's not exactly this quiver. You consider this have actually not some algebra which will be quasi isomorphic to A lambda. Namely, what I do, I have this my this neighborhood. And now I choose points P alpha in a connected component. You can see the smooth locus of lambda. It has several connected components, like here, this interval, this interval, and this interval. In each kind of component, choose at least one point of lambda smooth. Then you consider transversal Lagrangian disks. And endow with Z grading in the sense which I explained. Z grading using lift of some argument function. Then we get something from which we can hope to make homes. And now consider the following algebra: sum over all alpha beta. And I consider the inductive limit when time goes to plus infinity of C. And now you would do the following. If you get alpha and beta, you start to apply the flow, and then this disk start to move. And
the alpha what square?
Two-dimensional disk, what are you? Two denotes nothing. The alpha.
Two, it's one-dimensional in your picture. It's a graph, you take
transversal. Sorry, n dimensional, yeah. It's n dimensional disk, if I n dimension to n. You're right. In this case, it's a one dimensional disk. And I consider intersection points of, you apply exponent p times the flow, which I explained before, this Hamiltonian flow, respect to distance function, to d alpha and intersect with d beta. You get infinitely many points. Yeah, so this, I think the simplest example, if you take lambda is a circle. And if you get one guy and, let's see, and you start to apply this flow many, many times, you get things like this. Intersection points will be larger and larger set, and eventually get basis of monomials in Laurent polynomials. All these intersection points home in this category. From this disk itself, this inductive limit will be exactly you get all Laurent polynomials. Yeah, so that's a typical example. And what is the state of art? What is expected that alpha is alpha lambda is section of co-sheaf of algebras, maybe categories. And gamma in homotopy sense. And on smooth locus, maybe better categories, I would say. Maybe I said perfect I modules. And on smooth locus, this category is equivalent to finite dimensional complexes of the modules of abelian group. And globally, it's twisted a little by this second Stifel-Whitney class. One can shift, twist this sheaf of categories by second, by any class in H2 in Z mod 2. Of lambda smooth, yeah. And for example, in this one-dimensional example, if you consider triple point, then what will be locally this category? Locally, the category representation of quiver A2. We'll have three complexes, E1 and 2, E3, and they form exact triangle. And it will be the same as the representation of quiver A2, this exact triangle. So, on more general, if you get such guy with kind of k spikes, you get representation of quiver AK minus 1. Yeah, so that's a very beautiful story, which I will not talk to you.
If lambda is smooth, what is A lambda?
A lambda, if you forget about this Z-mod 2, it's chains, you consider, suppose it's connected manifold, and choose base, choose the base point, then you have a topological monoid, loops from the base point, it's a monoid. And I consider chains, singular chains of this monoid to get DG algebra, negatively graded. This will be a lambda. Yeah, that's, if it's a lambda is KP1 space, it's a group ring of the fundamental group. It's some generalization of group ring. Yeah, okay. Yeah, it's some nice object. Yeah, and what I want to say is that there was a kind of breakthrough work by David Nadler. He proposed a finite list of possible singularities in any given dimension. For example, in real dimension 2, it will be at most three-valent graph. It will be one value, maybe not just, maybe, so just question, it's about complexes and some exact triangles, the whole category. And it's called arboreal singularities in high dimensions. And what is not yet done, how to, so he deformed any kind of lambda without changing homotopy type to something with this nice singularities. Yeah, for example, for graphs, you can deform to some trees, yeah, kind of like that's a picture which doesn't change the category. And what is not done is how to construct this Maurer-Cartan class, to how to count holomorphic disks with the boundary on the singular Lagrangian, get some contributions. Yeah, it's, I think some people working on it, and it will be done in some finite future, at least for this Nadler's class of singularities. Yeah, so it will be, so it's almost good signs. No, and now I think I'll make a 5 minute break. I'll try to formulate certain conjecture. Unfortunately, because of troubles on both sides, it's not really yet mathematical conjecture. The conjecture is the following. X omega is, let's say, algebraic symplectic manifold. And we choose for definiteness, let's say, Poisson compactification. With some Poisson structure. And such that x bar minus x is, let's say, normal crossing divisor. And suppose also you get some class. Class B0 in H2 x bar r 2 pi z. I had some kind of seeds from which we can make uh, deformation quantization, and assume that I extend it to an analytic germ in H bar of quantum categories.
I do not understand. The previous was given. What do you extend? I mean, all this is given.
Yeah.
What do you extend?
No, suppose now I have a family of maybe just a second. And suppose I have a formal path to the Maurer Cartan space of the following DGL algebra. I consider R gamma of X bar and consider logarithmic polyvector field, logarithmic divisor. I have a form solution that this first derivative coefficients of H inverse will be omega inverse kind of Poisson will be this Poisson structure gamma of H to the power 1 will be gamma and some kind of formal path. Then I get a family of categories. I can twist them by also by B0. And what I want the things to be analytic germ in H analytic germ in H bar. That's some part. Then I kind of want to speak about object also analytically depending on H bar. And maybe H bar is here. Yeah, then for h bar less than sufficiently small, we should get a category of objects in quantized.
Maxim, when the conjecture ends?
Oh, it'll be very non-precise and very long. Yeah, that's the problem. Yeah, that's a formulation of kind of left hand side of conjecture. Then I get category of object in quantized category such that the restriction to the boundary is zero. Yeah, I recall you that by this logarithmic formality theorem, one get not only one category, but category for each divisor, for each intersection, then one have n functors. And then one can ask about object whose restriction to the boundary is zero. It will be analog of holonomic modules, so get some category. And what will be another category? When you get this thing, in particular, you can look what goes on inside of this story. You forget, you can see the map from the Maurer Cartan to the open part. And inside you get a class in H2 of X You can see the restriction, you can see the solution of Maurer-Cartan in you restrict to x, ergam of x, and the whole story. And then the symplectic case, there was a story in the first lecture which you missed. But yeah, that if you formally deform open symplectic manifold, just in analytic case, you get a formal path in second cohomology.
No, your B field is B zero is non-trivial.
B zero, it's kind of separate. It's just camp as a free addition. Forget about B zero. You get a class which is omega of h bar. And maybe you should add B zero later on. Yeah, because modulo 2 pi I z. Let me say. Which would be plus B zero. You get this class. And now what you do, you make Fukaya category of x is a real part of omega is symplectic form. And as B field will be B zero plus correction term. Real part of omega plus real part of correction term and plus imaginary part of correction term. Yeah, so we make this abstract Fukaya story, and the conjecture is that these are naturally equivalent. And it will be kind of Riemann-Hilbert correspondence in very general setup.
I don't like something. I mean, this you should probably scale omega in the real part by h.
Yes. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Yeah, that's it. That's it. And here you get imaginary part of omega divided by h. Yeah.
So h is real?
No. You should put h inside of real part. Omega.
Ah, yes. Yeah, you're right. Then it will be.
So you're taking h real?
No. All small complex numbers. That will be main point to put not real but arbitrary. So to say the things, I need to say something about Z grading. It's kind of automatic in this case. And let me explain why. When you get a complex symplectic manifold, the structure group of the tangent space is SP 2NC, yeah? And this is homotopy equivalent to unitary quaternion UN quaternionic. Quaternionic groups. And this is preserved, so it means that you, at each tangent space, have like hyperkähler geometry situation. And then it gives you certain, if you choose a structure, it gives you first some almost complex structure. But also, it gives you kind of like three symplectic forms. So your original symplectic form is omega 1 plus I times omega 2 on my manifold. So the real part will be omega 1. And then you get also three complex structure. And for complex structure compatible with omega 1, you will have holomorphic 2 form. And take exterior part of homomorphic 2 form, you get volume form at each point. And this volume form gives this grading procedure, as I explained. Yeah, so it's the grading is completely automatic in this case, and the space of choices is contractible. So that's a big conjecture. it's not mirror symmetry. It's also it's one category below looks like A model. You do some Fukaya category with holomorphic disks, and another category it's like B model. You do maybe deformation of perfect coherent sheafs, but it's on the same manifold, and there's no duality, and that's kind of new statement and not mirror symmetry. And in fact, I really don't understand deep reasons why it should be true. Yeah, it's.
It's too complex, symplectic. It's almost hyperkeller.
Yes, yes, but still, yeah. And there are really, yeah, it looks like first kind of almost a pseudoscience, because we don't have a Fukaya category, we don't really know convergence and so on, yeah. Let me explain why it it's really have something to do with Riemann hybrid correspondence. It's that's why it will be smooth algebraic variety of complex numbers. And in fact, I want to stress here that it's what we choose on a beta set. Suppose we have not one variety, but variety depending on hbar, kind of holomorphically depending. So why it sits, it's maybe some quantification. And all holomorphically depends on hbar. Like you have not one curve, but family of curves depending on hbar. Then the category we take a variety which is cotangent bundle, which is compactified. Fiber-wise, by Poisson manifold, I claim if we get this family of variety, we can consider particular family of these categories, and categories which we will consider category holomorphically depending on h bar will be vector will be d modules over Y h bar, kind of HD modules, vector bundles on Y h bar with h bar connection. And all the story is equivalence for h bar non equal to zero. Here we get a limit at h bar equal to zero. Consider what's called Higgs bundle. So consider coherent sheafs with compact support on cotangent bundle, and support and direct image should be a vector bundle on Y. Yeah, so we get these things, and this Fukaya category in this case will be for cotangent bundle. Consider the local object of this Fukaya category is representation of fundamental group.
Is it a conjecture or
something? No, this is people proved it. And how is the constructive functor? If you get cotangent bundle to let's for simplicity assume that Y is compact. It's true also for non-compact case. If Y is compact, people I think maybe Abu Zaid proved it. And the proof is the following. You get a cotangent bundle, and you put Fukaya category in whatever version it is, Lagrangian manifolds with local system, or the singular Lagrangian, blah, blah, blah. No. No, it's not a representation of P1. It's kind of a Fukaya category. It's going to be called constructible sheafs with locally of Y, with locally constant cohomology. Yeah, that's the right notion. Yeah, it's not representation of P1, yeah. What is kind of the reason? If you have object of Fukaya category, L, yeah, Fukaya category, maybe with something, then I consider different guys, consider cotangent fiber. It's another Lagrangian guy, it's a little bit non-compact, but it's not really a problem here, because the intersection will be compact, and when you get compactness space of disk, and get homes from one to another. Home from I to L is well defined, and you get some finite complex of vector spaces, finite dimensional complex of vector spaces, but this object, if you change shift Y, it will be Hamiltonian deformation. And it shows that its objects are isomorphic and it identifies homes. This gives you roughly this flat. Sorry?
That's part of other conjecture.
No. It's obvious,
yeah.
Spaces.
Yeah, Arnold conjecture eventually follows from all this stuff. Yeah, yes, yeah. And then that's how you map object Fukaya category to a local system, and then eventually people can handle to prove that it's equivalence. Yeah, but it's kind of very simple case. It's a local system, but we in last lecture explained some singularities, irregular singularities, and so on. This can be done add to the thing in the following way. At least for the case of contingent bundle of curve. Suppose it's Y is a OC is a curve. Then consider contingent bundle. Again, compactify. But actually, it'll be only first compactification. I will do something else. I remind you what I get kind of cotangent bundle, and at divisor at infinity, that projects to my curve Y. At this divisor, 2 has second order pole. Let's assume for simplicity that Y is compact curve. Then if I'm interested in some D modules with some singularities, what I do is start to make blow-ups. I start to make Poisson blow-ups. And if I make blow-ups, I can get different order of poles or different order of zeros of Poisson structures. And eventually, there will be certain divisors when I have first order pole. And these first order poles correspond to irregular terms in formal classification of D modules. Yeah, so I get this surface certain first order poles. And kind of semi-classical picture, which we considered spectral curves were something which intersect this divisor infinity only in this smooth point of this first order poles. But now I can do something new. I can take a point of this divisor and get first order pole and make again a blow up. When I make a blow up, exceptional divisor will have zero order pole, so it will be part of larger symplectic leaf. So I make a new symplectic manifold. And then I can do it several times. And eventually, if I have any curve in my cotangent bundle, by these blobs, I can achieve the situation that it's at infinity meets only first order poles. But after many, many blobs, I can make it compact completely. Yeah, so so this procedure gives some kind of modification of categories of D modules. If you look what you're doing here, yeah, essentially should choose if you do blow up once, you do the following things. This recall that divisors when order of pole of omega is equal to 1, they canonically identified with C. They have canonical coordinate. By
push the upper black
they are canonically identified with C and coordinates, it's better denoted by something called lambda. And just in the case of regular singularity, if you make blow up once, it will be this coordinate lambda here. And so if on each device I put, so if I fix some collection of finite collection of complex numbers for each such for each logarithmic divisor, this lambda I, and then I make blow up, I get a new points of the symplectic leaf. So what is correspond in terms of D modules? Just let's speak about regular singularity. Suppose I get on a formal disk, I get a bundle with connection with logarithmic poles. And all this data will say the following. I identify, so I get a bundle, interest not just meromorphic bundles, but bundles over CZ with such a delta will be delta 0 dz will be has no pole at 0, so it means that connection has first order pole. And then if you consider residue of the connection will be endomorphism of the fiber at 0. The data will be the following. I will identify E, will identify with direct sum over I. E0i, and residue delta preserves on E0i will be lambda I divided by h bar times identity operator. Yeah, so it so this will be all eigenvalues will be no Jordan blocks, and eigenvalues are fixed. And actually, it's quite a good formulation because, like, exponent of these numbers can coincide for certain h bar, but still I separated these logarithms. And if I make additional blow-ups, I can also handle Jordan blocks. I don't know what to do in higher dimensions, but this is kind of way to go from D modules to something which, in a classical limit, has compact support inside the symplectic manifold. And this will be a modification of category of D modules in this case. Really, you consider this formal classification, also choose some sublattices and such sums. Yeah, and there's a similar story in Fukaya, in Fukaya category. In fact, here there are kind of alternative theory, but I think this, the compact one is better. The alternative theory is consider not object with compact support, but such that restriction will be shifts with finite support on this union of logarithmic poles. Do not make blow ups at smooth points of log divisors. So we get another boundary condition, so restriction of zero, but it will be something. And on Fukaya side, you can see the partially wrapped Fukaya category.
But if we do blow ups, we consider
just compact, yeah. It will be slightly different category. And this partial wrapped is not Calabi-Yau. It's what's called pre-Calabi-Yau. It's and partially wrapped roughly means the following: this my manifold X. And now my Lagrangian lambda, for example, a single Lagrangian, can go to infinity in certain direction. And then I, when I define homes, I start to move a little bit things at infinity. Yeah. So it's some story. Maybe I'll return to it next time. And in this case, the relation with the Stokes filtration will be the following. It's kind of a rough picture. Stokes data. I recall you that the Stokes data we interpret geometrically in case of curves. Not Stokes data, it's irregular terms. We get a compact curve, we get some points, and then at points we get certain the Stokes diagrams. And this Stokes diagrams we can now extend to so conical real Lagrangian guys. So it will be some kind of non-compact. We get lambda sitting in cotangent bundle to surface, non-compact, singular Lagrangian. And the nice property here, this case, there's no correction. In this case, there's no correction from holomorphic disks. It will be exact Lagrangian. No deformation of A lambda. And then this A lambda, in this case, modules will be exactly a Betti description of Riemann-Hilbert correspondence. And it's related to the whole story. This complex story is that the cylinders go to this logarithmic devices infinity. And the picture how how to map from Fukaya category to this identify with Stokes data essentially the same. They consider homes with vertical fibers, but when approach a singular point, we deform them a little bit, and eventually we see these filtrations. Yeah, so it's.
So how is it the filtrations in this?
I think because the intersection points of the when we consider this vertical fibers approach singular point, then we'll kind of intersect the things. It's in several pieces, and that's roughly the story. You can try to think that object of Fukaya category is something with support close to this guy, and then the intersections with this vertical fibers will be like this. Similar thing also explains this Riemann-Hilbert correspondence for quantum modules. suppose my x is like this. I put the symplectic form. And I have algebra. Algebra will be C of, depending on h bar, z1 hat plus minus z2 hat plus minus modulus relation z2 hat z1 hat is exponent of h bar. Yeah, so I have this algebra. And again, one can. The compactification is, let's say, some toric surface. So we get toric surface, so it's a boundary, get a bunch of C star. Think of C stars. And if you have such Poisson surface, then we consider modules such that, let's say, in the classical limit, the curves which do not go to intersection points, zero-dimensional, they all go to other divisors. So in tropical limit, you get some something curve which goes tropically on several directions. Eventually, one can make blow-ups at these points and make the thing compact. If you want to go to one language or go to this wrapped Fukaya, if you go to another language, actually wrapped Fukaya is not a very bad case, at least for absolute value of q less than one. Now for so it means that h is not in IR. Or actually, how to map Fukaya category? How to map to coherent sheaves on elliptic curve? Plus two anti-Hadamard Maxim filtration, which I explained in the last lecture. Yeah, let's assume in this picture, in this diagram, I do not have vertical directions. Apply it to the transformation and don't have vertical direction. And then I get a vector bundle with two anti-Hadamard similar filtration. The picture is the following. You consider, like in previous story, you consider home from object, which will be the following. It will be for each ZW, you can see the C star z1 equal to z and w arbitrary. It will be my whatever c star cross c star. I consider some fiber, which will be Lagrangian submanifold, and local system will be of rank 1, and z1 and monodromy is multiplication by w. And I consider this is unobstructed object of Fukaya category. Then I can make a home from this thing to your object. And what we get? We get something holomorphically depending on bundle on C cross is coordinate Z times C cross is coordinate W. It's not locally constant because the deformations are not exact. But there is some, again, piece of wisdom in this Fukaya category. If you deform Lagrangian manifold by non-Lagrangian deformation, it gets a first cohomology class of it, the speed of deformation. It's equivalent to make local system with this first cohomology class. And then it's easy to see that this holomorphic bundle has flat connection a long foliation, kind of holomorphic one foliation given by vector field z du dz minus 2 pi I over h bar w du dw. So on this star square, you get this holomorphic, this homsa don't change this direction, and the quotient space will be elliptic curve. Exactly this elliptic curve. And similarly, if you approach now go z goes to zero to infinity, then this intersection points will separate in several groups and you get filtrations. Yeah, so that's automatically. If z goes to zero or infinity, you will get two filtrations. Yeah, it all looks like some kind of pseudoscience. Yeah, because I cannot have get precise definition of okay category, I don't know convergence, blah blah blah. But there are some corollaries which are completely rigorous. At least one get rigorously formulated conjectures. This correspondence for Riemann-Hilbert correspondence for quantum torus. Hypothetically generalize to high dimension. Generalize to high dimensions. I can see the C star cross C star standard to power to n. The algebra will be AH tensor n. I can see this is product of arbitrary number of copies. What I can formulate, I will not give complete details now, but I can formulate hypothetical equivalence. N, yes, you're right. Real norm is at less than one, and assume that it's this. Then holonomic h bar to power n modules are equivalent to certain explicit category. Which can be described completely rigorously using all this machinery. And the category is the following. It will be inductive limit of some full subcategories. Under what set I consider Lagrangian funds in z to in R to n. What is it? Maybe I denote them again lambda. Lambda is a finite union some finite union of some pieces. And lambda alpha is is a convex full dimensional cone in a certain Lagrangian subspace. And alpha is defined over rational numbers. And cone with kind of rational, it will be also rational cone. And with the properties that intersection of lambda alpha with lambda beta, interior of lambda alpha with lambda beta is empty for alpha non equal to beta. Yeah, so good. There's some kind of, I don't know how to draw four dimensions. You get some kind of arbitrary correction of this convex cone meeting each other. And then for this correction, one can make certain DG. Yeah, this is a typical singular Lagrangian guy. And then we get this small neighborhood, and then we get this whole algebra in lambda. And in particular, we get this transversal disks and homes between them. We get certain DG category over integers, even such that objects are set of alphas. Using the and this in fact can be calculated completely explicitly, because in this conical situation it's easy to reduce to conical in cotangent directions case and reduce to series of sheafs with some micro local support, so it will be totally elementary object. Yeah,
in the one-dimensional example or two-dimensional example, you have the Tate curve, so to speak.
Yeah.
So in the higher dimensions, are you getting some toroidal degenerations of abelian varieties related to those fans?
No. There's no abelian. No, it will be power of the curve at the end of the day. It's nothing. Yeah.
Just one
H. Yeah, I have one H. Yeah. Yeah, but what is the story? We have this algebra, we have this category, maybe called C lambda. And now consider another category, consider perfect complexes of the nth power of elliptic curve. V is my elliptic curve, yeah. You get a certain another category. B. And for each Lagrangian rational, then this category, there was something nice here, SP to NZ, maybe universal cover acts on B by Fourier Mukai transforms. Then B contains certain category B0, B maybe horizontal. I'll explain in second way. Horizontal will be perfect complexes. This is finite support or zero dimensional support on e to power n. Just bunches of points and some commuting nilpotent operators. This category is invariant under J ln Z. It's preserved by action of J ln Z, intersecting by automorphism of En. And then it implies that. By equivalence, if you consider quotient space, it will be kind of like Z covering, associated with gradient, of the set of all rational Lagrangian subspaces. J ln Z stabilizer of one subspace, and from one subspace and go to another, is a covering of space of rational Lagrangian subspaces. That means that for each subspace you get, if you choose this, Z grading, you get a well-defined category. And now this kind of right-hand side of Riemann-Hilbert correspondence will be the following. It will be functors from C lambda to B, category of functors, such that for each object alpha, maps to object in this corresponding in subcategory corresponding to Lagrangian subspace L alpha. Yeah. In the case when n equal 1, you get exactly this original this picture with these filtrations, because you just get a bunch of rational rays. This subcategory will be semi-stable sink with the slope, and then you get, if you analyze what the sink, it means you get two filtrations of the sink, yeah. Now, so that's one kind of non-empty and precise statement. And it's amazing that it works in higher in precise conjecture, yeah. And amazing, it works in high dimensions, so it's much it's kind of cleaner than D modules when you have this irregular singularity. So it's really much simpler. And another statement, which is almost precise, that when you get this in big correspondence, we get some families of quantum spaces, and then Fukaya categories. But then different families can give the same symplectic, same classes in H2. Like, for example, consider D modules, and you change the curve. Yeah, so you get extra parameters which you cannot see on Fukaya side. And then it says that, forget about Fukaya categories, it says that this object with compact support in the quantum cases, they're isomorphic under some kind of isomonodromy deformation. Yeah, that's it's purely, it makes sense even of formal power series. Yeah, so it's kind of interesting statement by itself without referring to Fukaya categories, because we get two more parameters on complex side.
Can you give me an example?
No, you for example, have family of curves depending on h-bar. And consider h-bar connections, the claims it's you get equivalent categories for any two families. Constant family or non-constant family. Yeah. Okay. Thank you.